Hi all. It's almost evening. So good evening. Okay, I need to have this. Hope you guys can hear me loud and clear. Yeah, hi. So good evening. I'm Dhanraj, Bhosle, CEO of Cognota Healthcare. Cognota Healthcare is an offshoot of a 20-year-old IT firm based out of US, IndiSoft. We have been into healthcare for almost 10 years now, and we have been customizing a lot of hospital management softwares across India, but primarily Mumbai and Maharashtra. Cognota Healthcare is just your next door healthcare IT partner, and when we say that, we believe in that, because we become more of a consulting partner for all your IT needs. 100 clientels, 1,000 man years experience. We are process driven, mostly focused only on custom IT applications, may it be cloud based, may it be standalone systems that your hospital uses. Apart from that, as a small introduction of Cognota Healthcare, I'd like to tell you about a recent case study. I'll make it very brief, but it's quite interesting. A customized hospital management software that we developed for a neurology hospital in Surat. It was quite a journey for us. It took quite amount of time, resource, as well as thought process to get into this. So let me just, I know, you know, the HMS systems, most of you know it, but I would like to say it's just not a system, you know, when we encounter a lot of doctors. We cater to a token size of 50 to 100 bed hospitals across Bombay and Maharashtra. Most of the doctors that we encounter, the system that we talk about is just a system for many of them, unless and until there is customization required for their hospitals. So that's what I say, that it's just not a system which helps in registering the patient, but it's a nerve center. So I've been hearing a lot of senior people, Desai sir, Gaurav, talking about hospital infra and very bigger things in entire infrastructure and planning of an hospital. So that was the body of the hospital. That was something, the exterior of the hospital, the aesthetics of it, and the work and functionality of it. So I would like to take some part of it where we talk about the brain of the hospital. And that's exactly why we call it as a nerve center of the hospital. I know there are a lot of HMSs or hospital management system available across the service lines. There are some specialized, there are big names, there are smaller names. Someone who are only catering to 50 to 100 bed, someone more than 200, cloud-based, n numbers of HMS. The difference that we make is we are into customization of it. So I don't want volumes of business or volumes of client who talks about I need an HMS, they take it, they use it, and after a period of 3 months or 6 months, they say, okay, this module is not working. The pharmacy module is not talking with the tally module. The billing module is not working with the resource module. So the kind of HMS that we have developed it on a period of years, of 10 years, which have almost 80 to 90% of inputs from reputed doctors, from different indications, say diabetes, neurology, you name it, oncology. Having said that, the platform is a web-based platform. Now, that's again one of the most important factors that's happening in India, at least, that most of the doctors that we are visiting or the hospitals that we are visiting, some are using a standalone software which is probably not accessible outside. They are land-based systems. So we are a web-based application, okay, where even if you're sitting right now over here, you can just access your mobile, see what's happening in the hospital. And that's just not how many patients are registered, but more than that. We're talking about a pure analytics, pure, I would say, intelligence in the software that allows you to understand how is your hospital functioning weekly, monthly, half yearly, you name it. So when we did about, let's come to the case study. We'll talk about what happened, what we did, why the HMS systems are required, why this particular stuff was required. The owners of the hospitals are four very brilliant-minded neurologist from Surat, very excited, very IT and tech savvy, which we usually don't find in doctors, but yeah, no offense in that. The need arises because of the people who wants better healthcare. You're talking about a lot of applications that are coming in. I do have one application in my mobile right now which talks about reviews of doctors just across any geography or any demographics. I would like to choose a good doctor in that particular area. That's me as a person, I'm not a doctor. So people are becoming more demanding in terms of what kind of system or what kind of hospital they are registering themselves into or their family members. So the need actually got into the next level when people are saying that I got an SMS from my doctor asking about my health and reminding me about next appointment, he cares. So when we say the statement, not many of the hospitals, I would say, would have a post-follow-up requirement or post-follow-up connect with the patients. There are no automated patients reminding calls. I do understand that there are a lot of other applications available, but the kind of interaction that we had with our client right now, these were the issues. They were not able to follow up with their clients or the patients who left the hospital after a treatment. Nothing after post-operational outputs, nothing in terms of developing a doctor-patient intimacy by using a separate system. They're using a normal SMS gateway which was not integrated in the system, which was not even automated. So at the end of the day, what we saw is doctors are using 10 different applications for 5 different processes. And we was like, wow, I mean, you're talking about teleconsultation, they're talking about Skype. For appointment booking, they have Practo. For patient registration, they have third software. For billing, they had another one. For pharmacy and inventory, they had another one. And we said, okay, fine, let's stop it here and let's try to solve your problem. There was a gentleman who was sitting here in the morning who spoke to me. He actually gave me a very good insight. You know, that different between US and India is that US have, and these are the exact words, you know, correct me if I'm wrong or if he's wrong, US have one system which caters to everything. You don't have to see 10 different systems to allow you to manage your hospital. But in India, unfortunately, or fortunately, we have 10 different systems to manage a single, you know, patient as such, I would say. And I was very curious and very surprised to hear about cost savings and revenue findings and stuff. When we did the system for this particular hospital, we boiled it down to the bottom line. So when I'm saying bottom line, it's a true exact bottom line about how by using one particular software which is customized to your hospital, you can save tremendous amount of revenues by calculating the net deficits of your cash, of your hospital, medicines, inventory, in real-time manner. So when I say real-time, I'm talking about web-based. So I don't have to wait for something that has to come to me as a report after a period of 15 days. I don't want a software which says that after a month I will generate a report which will give you something and you can do your precise decision-making systems over there. No, you're not doing that. So the goal was to build a more humane intelligence system. Now, when I say most of the systems are intelligent, but when I'm talking humane, there were a little bit of criteria that the clients or the doctors who gave us. Say, for example, someone told me about, okay, the Bombay Hospital guys said that they actually treat a lot of BPI clients, you know, bioportal-like BPL clients. So how do you segregate those kind of clients? Because they are also your patient. Only because they are BPL, you need not talk about not interacting with them. So the idea with these doctors who are very wonderful in terms of their intelligence, in terms of taking care of the patient, they wanted more humane system. How do I connect with these people? How do they feel at home when they are in the hospital? How do they also feel that they're connected with the doctors even if they're outside the hospital? So this was a goal and very simple strategy we followed with this one-liner. When we met, they were around, you know, it took us around 45 days just to gather the data of the doctors about what they wanted to say. We just heard them, what they wanted to say. 15 meetings, up and down, Bombay Surat, extended number of 25 data sets points. So when I'm saying 25 data points, these were the points, were the pain points that the doctors had in terms of using the existing HMSs. So pardon me, like the existing HMS or the system that the doctors were using were four different systems. So you can imagine four different doctors, four different mind coming to one place, opening one neurology hospital. It was a task for us. You know, trying to understand each one's vision, goal, and making sure that all their intelligence is built up into one system, which takes care of the entire hospital. We talked about 120 days of development and implementation, which is roughly four months, because the hospital was just coming up. So we did have that time and luxury to develop that entire entity into a very customized intelligence system for these guys. So when we're talking about this, it also comes about with 365 days of support and development. What happens after 4 months? Do we guys leave them? No, it's kind of a partnership. That's why we said that we want to come as more of a consulting partner. I was talking to someone right now, and I did understand that once the HMS is or a system is implemented at your hospital, there might be inputs that might come after 6 months. What happens after that? We are taking this as an investment for us, where we are the tech partners for this particular hospital, understanding the intelligence and building that system for a year. So we are trying to understand over here, I'm trying to tell you a case study where the HMS over here is a standalone web-based system which can be customized to your requirements, right? So let's see what were the prime data points, what were the problems. Paper documentation, 7,000 patient profile, past 10 years of data, paper, what should we do? That was the point. Okay, we have a document management system, let's convert and digitalize this. We are going to do that. Patient history, they don't know what patient, who patient came at what point of time. So once the documentation is getting into digitalization, the doctors are going to go, it's going to create a unique patient ID for every patient that has actually came past 3 years, 5 years, and the data is going to be on a secured cloud server. So anytime the doctor wants to access it, they're going to make sure that just with a click of a button and a unique ID number, all the patient history is going to be there into their screen. Automated prescription was a problem. They wanted the prescription directly go to the pharmacy, which is a very small point of time where a lot of patients probably, they just lose out the prescription, they don't know what is it. When the prescription was given on X date, they came after 3 months, they don't have the papers, so what happens? So we have talked about something in terms of automated prescription profiling for a lot of patients, for the doctors. With a click, the prescription gets generated and no one but the doctor controls it. Multiple patient management tool, exactly. They had Skype, they had Practo, they had billing softwares, 10 different softwares, and nothing to be customized or nothing to sync in. That was one of the most primary pain points. Patient counseling videos. They wanted something, once a patient comes, I need to talk to him, the counseling session needs to get recorded. Which is the system that they were using? They were using a camera on their on their laptop and an external hard disk, which they don't know where they used to keep. So you're talking about very intimate and critical patient data just flowing out of your system with a jiffy. What we did, we integrated intelligence system into the HMS so that anytime the patient comes in, there is an automatic video presentations or video getting recorded and pulled into the server in a secured place. Many points were considered while doing this. We say that the prescription is this, we say that the cost is this, the patient comes back, say, nahi sahab, doctor sahab, aapne cost kuch alag bola tha us waqt, abhi kuch alag bol rahe ho. These were the ground realities, and that was the reason they wanted something into patient counseling videos. Surprisingly, I spoke to someone in the morning again regarding the same thing, and it was related to IVF. They have an IVF clinic in Haryana, I guess, and he said that, Dhanraj, this is actually the need of an hour, because once we are interacting with a lot of couples, and when we say these are the percentage of chances and this is how it might go, they come back saying that, okay, no, I need my money back because it didn't happen. So they have implemented a hardware and system as an external system to record patient counseling videos just to have a defense mechanism built up into the entire system. Pharmacy concerns, I'm sure most of the doctors might have over here, in-house or external, manipulations done, not done. The top management doesn't know what's the exact bottom line, how the inventory has been maintained. So there is a kind of intelligence that is going into the system where the pharmacy is going to be operated at a very good revenue numbers, reducing all the manipulations, all the internal issues that are happening in the pharmacy. And I'm pretty much sure that once that system is getting implemented, because these are standard systems which are required by any hospital who has an inbound pharmacy. So I was talking to one of the person over here, they also have the same issue. And she actually told me that if this has been created, then you know, it's easy for us to do this. And I said, yeah, we are doing that actually. So it's kind of a very good notion that once we are developing this system and giving it to the hospital, it's going to be more of a standard and required system for any hospital, namely 50 to 100 or 200 as such. Operation theater videos, post-discharge connect, as I rightly said, something related to getting back to the patient, how are you, automated systems, which probably creates patient intimacy or patient care profile, even if after he's out of the hospital, probably a small message which says, happy birthday, happy anniversary. So this post-discharge connect was missing in these people. They didn't know how many patients were a new patient and a regular coming patient. They were only coming with the confidence that was there into the doctors and the hospital. And we integrated something as a patient development program in it, which talks about a lot of automation and patient caring profiles. Hosting and security was a problem. Again, I spoke to someone and they said that it's a web-based system, how secure it is. I told them that, you know, Pentagon was hacked very recently. Before that, the SDFC and Access servers were hacked. When we talk about hosting and security, we are talking about cloud servers. This system is basically one of the most robust system, I would say, hosted and, you know, operated through cloud servers. We don't have to worry about the hosting and security because we are talking about dedicated cloud servers to you. I wouldn't know that if the doctor knows what are servers that are actually dedicated, which are physical servers and cloud servers, but cloud servers has gained their own, interest very recently, considering the kind of security they give, you know, kind of ease of development or deployment they give, you know, and again, the reduced cost. We're talking about 70 to 80% reduced cost if you're actually using a cloud server rather than physical servers. You know, and that's what we have actually helped them. You reduce the cost of their internal server requirements. Scaling up was an issue. Again, I'm just talking real time. I spoke to someone today and he was saying that I have an hospital, I want to scale it up, another three clinics. So will you charge patient-wise? Will you be able to give me that scalability and stuff? How if the burden increases on the system, how if there are 100 patients right now and suddenly there are 500 patients, will it take? So that's what was taken in consideration also over here. We have developed the modules and the system in such a way that no matter if it scales up to 50 to 100 patients even per day, it will be able to handle those kind of issues. You name it, if they want to scale it up to entirely different geography or demographics. Right now they're in Surat, they plan to have something in Delhi, they have planned to have something in Hyderabad. It should not be a problem deploying the entire system to these regions. So scaling up and extending it to the outskirts support was not an issue. These were the prime data points that we actually cleared out. The idea was to just make sure that we map the entire typical patient journey straight from entry to the exit and post-exit. That was an idea. So the goal was to develop a humane system. The idea was to cover the entire journey of the patient. So a smart web-based HMS system hosted on dedicated cloud server which will cover the entire patient journey from admission to post-discharge. I really don't know if there are any such systems right now. I'm not saying that we are the one. We do everything under the sun. There might be, but this is the need of an hour right now. A hospital may be 20 bedded or say 100 and more. You do require a system which will actually cater to real-time requirements of the patient. And we believe that that needs to be done because for the patient, the only source of inspiration is the doctor. For patient, the only God present on this earth is doctor. So having a dedicated HMS, which is more humane and which actually talks about your patient and a patient-centric approach will help you get this system in. So the system was developed. It is still under deployment. Few things have to be incorporated. So this system won't just contain and transmit information. It's going to compute it. So when I'm saying it's going to compute it, it's actually going to help a lot of patient outcomes, diagnostics, how the revenues are going, how many patients did I see, how many patients came during that area, during that region, from that region, during that period. So when I say it will compute, I would not read out probably, but I'll just take few points from here, that it would actually help in a lot of patient outcomes and diagnostics by, you know, supporting diagnostic and therapeutic decision making, gathering all relevant information, lab results and everything, you name it, under one place. You just need role-based logging for the system. A doctor has entire master admin. A pharmacy guy has a pharmacy module. Inventory guy has an inventory module operating itself. So creating a humane-based, more intelligent system which actually talks about analytics. Now, if I'm right, and with my limited information that I have, we were talking about revenue saving, cost saving. We were talking about reducing the cost. So when we went to this hospital, we talked about three reports which will actually give the entire scenario of the hospital in just one page. In just one page. You talk about how did they perform as a pharmacy. We talk about how did they perform as giving service to the patients. It talks about how they made money. Okay, now when we talk about money, I guess it's not a taboo because you do require substantial bottom line, a good profitability business, and how is that going to happen? That's only going to happen by real-time data. We are not talking any assumptions over here. We are not talking about a third party coming in trying to tell you, okay, these were the patients, these are the revenues. We're talking about a really intelligent system which you can actually operate just by the click of your hand. You name it. You have a tab, you can do it. You are in US, you need to understand which are the patients coming in, you just have to log in. So when I'm saying that so easily, it's not that easy because the system is very complex. A lot of intelligence has gone in. I would actually like to focus more on improving patient health outcomes, you know, and some of the questions, you know, if it's a neurology hospital, I'm sure that these are basic questions or basic parameters that are being interacted or incorporated into the system. We were able to bring in more than 50 odd questions. Say for example in Surat, what if there is a pandemic? How do I make sure that the patients are routed to the different hospital? What if a patient comes with X yojana? He is entitled to some yojana and he again comes. Do you have that data? It reflects on your screen. We're talking about the amount of patients who are suffering from X kind of disorder, you know, from past 3 years, and what are the prescription or what are the things that they may require in next 3 months. So most of the things are actually still in a gray area with many hospitals, with many doctors, because the kind of doctors that we interacted from 20 to 100 bedded hospital, they are the one doing everything under the sun right now. They are having negotiation with the vendors. They are the final decision makers. They have to choose the color of the windows, everything. So when I say this, that if this intelligence system is there, why don't we prefer customizing it through your ideas? The ideas are yours. It develops as a system, and you get a system which is more robust and develops for you as the time goes. So we at Cognota believe in that. We are not me too kind of software. We don't want to be called as pan-India expansion plans with 3,000 installations and bringing no value to the client. I would rather say I would have 50 installations in next 3 years, but these are the most intelligent system that we would actually deploy, say for example, in 50 or 100 bed hospitals in coming years. So that is the plan. That's what we did with Surat Hospital. I will be more open to discuss this in details in case if you need more details of it, because if we talk about HMS, trust me, it's more than a white mammoth, you know, which is also, which is never existing. So that's the end of the slide, and I would like to end this by saying that it's easy for an idea to percolate, you know. It's good to be an entrepreneur. It's good to talk about bigger things into the hospital management, you know, facility and infrastructure. But at the end of the day, it comes to the bottom line, and below that it comes, and above that it comes to the value that your hospital will create for your patient. And I'm sure that you believe if you create value for the patient, you actually don't have to worry about the bottom line, right? So that's what we believe, and we're keeping that as a idea. Those are the group of companies that we have, which actually caters into banking, finance, healthcare, and Cognota Healthcare is one of the foremost into healthcare segment in customized IT solutions. And I would like to end this year, and I hope I am right on the time right now, and I'm looking for the questions if you have. Yes, sir.
On that, because if you look at India, it's about 48 to 52% post-operative recovery rate.
Exactly.
Whereas there is one hospital in Europe,
exactly,
called Queen Elizabeth Hospital, which is working on a software system which has improved their post-operative recovery rate to 96.8%.
Absolutely.
Which is phenomenally high and which is really good. And I would like to know that. Do you have something where you could do something to improve the patient care through your software? The compilation of data is irrelevant. To me, it makes no sense, you know, whether it is through software or hardware or whatever. So can you tell me or enlighten me on this?
Yes, so we have a module in physiotherapy. I hope I'll be able to cater to your question. Now, when we're talking about post-operative procedures or post-operative caretaking of the patient, I'll talk specifically in the physiotherapy section that we have. Now, most of the post-operative stuff requires a good amount of physiotherapy for a patient, right? We're talking about a geographically inclined, service module. A patient in Surat, say for example, Delhi, he is in Janpat, he gets operated, he goes to Noida. He can't come to, again, Janpat, just to make sure that his doctor is giving him a good physiotherapy exercise, right? So what we do? The doctors give him written stuff. He goes to Noida. Patient starts feeling that I'm good. He's again coming back after the exercise. He's not doing it. And what happens after that? He's again coming into the same cycle, possibly for another surgery after a long period of time. So here, we're talking about incorporation of telemedicine as one of the, modules in it. A patient sitting X kilometers away, he wants to have a consultation done after surgery, he need not come to the hospital. There will be online study resources and materials available, which are free of cost, where the patient can just log in, see what is happening after, because this is about physiotherapy, it's very easy because it's moments. We're talking about something into neurosurgery, okay? Now the patient is not in a profile where he is able to do him by self, right? But his son, their relatives might be able to do. So what we are going to do in this is, after the post-surgery stuff, there are going to be online teleconsultation modules where the patient and the family doesn't have to come to the hospital to take any consultation, may it be exercise, may it be prescriptions. In this way, for this hospital, they think that it will help the patient recover more faster. And the idea is to do that for them. They don't want to attend the same patient for an extended hour where they actually can bring in a new patient, make him well, and again send him back. So I guess those teleconsultation modules are going to help in this system for this particular hospital again to help the patient recover more faster. I hope if I, and yeah, and if I say patient-centric or patient campaigns that the hospitals are going to do it, these campaigns are going to be like a very subtle campaigns where the patient and the relatives are going to get messages, emails, you know, periodic updates about how's the patient. It's not, they are not going to be telecalls, they're not going to be calling systems, no. They're going to be a subtle reminder messages for the patient as well as the, what do you say, the relatives. So these are the few stuff that have been incorporated in this system, which will probably help patient improve their lifestyle. So that's exactly what was the pain point in the previous slides. You know, if you see, post-discharge connect was the thing that they wanted. You know, so over here, this has been very critical for them. And if I talk about business or the bottom line, we're talking about a classical 80-20. I'm talking about patients who are there, who need my care, would actually probably come back, make sure that it goes on a continuous life cycle mode. So I hope I just answered your query. Okay. We can.
This appears to be a software more on database, basically. What is the inputs that are given to it? What he's looking at is that we need a software that will tell us what went wrong, where, and how to improve the system.
Exactly.
So does it have interactivity? With
yes. Yes.
Is it
so
interactive?
Yes, it's interactive. I'll tell you how. So very recently we have, and that's a good point I was about to make to the next level, because if I'm not me too, what is else I am? So very recently we have forged a joint venture with IIT Bombay, where we are integrating artificial intelligence in the system. So when the data points are calculated, they're calculated in terms of numbers, words, and figures. So once that data gets piled up, this artificial intelligence coding will help you be more interactive with the software. So this software is going to give you a lot of insights by its own, right? So that's there. I mean, that's in the place. This system doesn't have it, but yes, in association with IIT Bombay, we're going to launch it very soon with an artificial intelligence angle to it. Anything else, guys? I mean, I guess it's, I'm still there at, you know, by evening over here, so you have that time, and if I can talk to someone who have that queries. Yes, sir, last question, I guess.
Can your system integrate the real-time data, clinical data capturing in the hospital? Say patient is in intensive care unit and he is being constantly monitored with various parameters. Can they be integrated in the system, and the same could be available on a web basis to the clinician outside the hospital so that he can monitor the patient's condition? See, this can it be incorporated? Because
yes,
every monitoring system has its own software, which probably can complement to your software.
Right.
Something can be worked out.
It's actually a web-based, all fully functional intelligence system. When I'm saying this, it actually integrates and takes the data real-time. Now, when I'm saying real-time, say for example, a patient comes in, his blood reports are ready, okay? Now, those system needs to speak to my HMS. Once you say it's entered, you are in US, if it's critical, it comes onto your profile as a doctor.
Okay, and same system can capture this data in a format which can later be analyzed?
Yes, that's exactly what the system is. So all these data sets are compiled to a final analytics sheet where you get a complete analysis.
Can you also collaborate with the cancer surgeon, suppose Dr. Deepak Parikh, who sees a patient in the OPD,
right,
and has certain parameters which must be listed,
right,
and captured.
Yes.
Because at present this system doesn't cater to that, clinical data capturing.
Right. So when I'm talking about clinical data capturing, is it the core clinical part of it?
Yes.
So it does capture. I have not elaborately done it.
So basically in the patient history and whatever the clinical findings,
yes.
Is it a free text entry or is it that everything is a drop table and you mark that?
No, it's a text entry.
Then how do you analyze it? That's the biggest problem.
Yeah, so what happens is...
I'll just tell you, the problem with doctors, I'm being a doctor myself, I can say it's pain in abdomen, someone will write abdominal pain, someone will write pain in abdomen right side.
Right.
It all means pain in abdomen, upper abdomen, lower abdomen. And that's what doctors, you know, some of them write flowery language, somebody will be restricted to that.
Right.
So that's the biggest problem we have had. We have done something very similar 3 years ago.
Okay.
What you're talking about, including the SMS. The moment he leaves my clinic, in fact, he gets an SMS that your next appointment is on such and such a date. And 3 days prior to that appointment, he gets a reminder that your appointment is scheduled.
Right.
So this we have implemented, but our biggest bugbear has been to get doctors to get into the drop table system and stick to those words only and not write their own words.
Exactly.
So that's the biggest challenge.
There is an automated suggestion system, like what we do in Google. We try to type a patient, then it suggests you a complete line, right? So it's kind of a system that's getting into this where standard lines or standard text or standard prescription details are going to get implemented over here. So that even if it's the third partner who is actually prescribing something, the fourth partner actually knows, this is how it is. So that's there in the system. It's not only a text-based stuff, but as you rightly said, it's not even drop-down, but it's a free, you type it, it pops. The recent Google stuff. I guess.
We'll move on to the next.
Sure.